Good morning, guys, and welcome back. I'm going to show you how I made this from a picture frame that used to look like this. This cost about $3 at Hobby Lobby, but you can also get them in the Goodwill stores. You can find these all over the place, and they're really cheap, and you can do a nice little grouping of these in whatever room you want to match whatever style you want in that particular room. So here's how I got this done. First, you want to take the frame apart and just make sure that you use some alcohol to clean the glass off. Especially when I get these things from anywhere, I actually rinse the whole thing down with alcohol. Then the next thing is I'm going to put that aside to dry, and I'll slow this down a little bit because I want to show you the easiest way to cut napkins. It can be a bit challenging when you're trying to cut napkins because they're so thin and flimsy. So you want to take any kind of a stiffer piece of paper. We get so much junk mail, I just reach into the recycling and pull out. I actually prefer magazine pages or magazine covers because they're nice and crisp. Just take the one layer off of the napkin if you've got a three-layer napkin. And to make it easier, I also cut out sections at I cut out sections at a time, and then I take just the top two layers. I use a repositionable glue stick and I put it on the back of the image. This is a very bad glue stick. Let me get another glue stick. Make sure you have fresh repositionable glue sticks. Now this is just the top two layers of the napkin. I place it down over the scrap paper, and now I can cut out my image with my, first I'll just remove the excess with the larger scissors, and then I'm going to go back in with the smaller curved decoupage scissors. And these things work wonders when you're trying to cut out patterns that are a little bit more exact, these small scissors. And I will have links down below for these scissors along with some other products that you'll need to do this. And just keep one thing in mind. When you are cutting these napkins, you don't have to be too exact. We know flowers are never perfect. They've got rounded edges. And you can see here, I'm not cutting these tiny little stems. So you don't need to get too carried away. You just want to cut out the basic image. So I'm just going all around and I'm basically cutting out the shape of a leaf, not exactly the leaf that they have on here. And I'm going to finish going around this whole piece so that now we're left with this. Then you just dampen your fingertips and pull the napkins away. What will happen is, ideally, you're going to pull away that top layer. And since the napkins are so delicate, you just want to be careful that you're not yanking anything away. Just carefully pull each section away so that you're not tearing anything. And if you're gentle enough, you'll be okay with this. And then what you're left with is just this top layer. Now we're going to take our DecoArt napkin decoupage glue. I don't use any other decoupage glues but DecoArt. And I'm pouring a little bit of it into a smaller jar because this will keep your decoupage glue a lot more pure. You'd ever get those clumps in there or like a little hair or something? When you're using this small jar, that doesn't happen. Now I'm flipping this image over because we want to make sure we're decoupaging the back of the image. So this is face forward on the glass, and you want to take a little bit of decoupage, the napkin decoupage glue. You want to make sure you're using napkin decoupage glue. And guys, the only decoupage glue that I work with is this DecoArt, so I can't and won't respond to any questions about any other decoupage glue. Now what you want to do is start in the center and be very gentle. But in the center, you place down a little dab of the decoupage glue and almost work in a star or asterisk type of pattern. So this way you're pushing the wrinkles out, you're getting the image flat down on the surface, and as long as you're gentle and careful, I just had a little bit of a wrinkle there, so I used the other end of the brush to pick it up gently. And you see how I'm working outward? This is going to prevent wrinkles. You may get one or two. It's not a bad thing. But this will help prevent tearing and wrinkles and bubbles, anything like that. And I'm going to move into each section and do this. So right here, you see how I'm going in this outward pattern? And then up here, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going in this outward type of pattern. I'm keeping this going in real time so that you can see what I'm doing, because this is probably the most important part of this project, getting this napkin down nice and neatly. And I'll just speed this up a little bit. You don't need to see me do the whole thing in slow motion or fast, regular time rather. And now what I'm going to do is, once this is all done, I'm going to put this aside to dry. And then when it's dry, I added another coat of decoupage glue around the image. As you can see here, I am extending a lot of decoupage glue all the way out to the edges. So I want to show you what I did next. This decoupage glue, while it's still wet, I took a dampened sponge brush and I pounced the glue in all around the image. So let me show you this cool effect that this gives our glass. As this dries, you can see how it will give a nice, pretty type of image. It dries clear, but instead of the glass being one flat piece, it dries with kind of a clear, blurry effect that hopefully you'll be able to see in the pictures a little bit later. So I'm going to leave this to dry, and it is dry now, but I'm going to point something out. I'm about to apply chalk paint to the back of this. I made two of these. One of them I experimented with using just the plain glass, and the other one I experimented with using that mottled effect where I use the pouncer brush on the glass. You'll see it in the next image, but you won't see it on this picture. You still want to follow these instructions. I am using a fine artist's brush, and to make this napkin pop, I am adding the DecoArt chalk paint all around the back of the napkin. I'm trying to be as precise as I can. You need very bright light. But if you'll notice, when you add the paint to the back of the napkin, it will make the napkin pop. Do you see here? I'm trying to do this so you can see it. I'm applying the paint on the back, and the images will come out a lot more. I actually did two layers of this with the chalk paint. So I let it dry. Now here's the glass I was talking about. You see this nice, now that it's dry, how it's got this really pretty mottled effect? And how, look at how it makes the napkin pop, because we put the white paint on the back and I put two coats of the chalk paint just over the image, letting it dry in between. Now I want to take a stencil, and the stencil can be the stencil of your choice. You can use the paint of your color. One of the reasons that we put the white chalk paint on the back of our image was because we wanted to make sure the image stands out, and then the stencil will just be the extra pretty detail you put around the outside of it. So you can see our picture is facing up. We want to flip it over again because we're always doing all the work on the back. And I'm going to take some tape first and secure this stencil to the table I'm working on so that nothing slips around. And now I'm going to take my freshly rinsed pouncing brush, and I'm using a different color chalk paint. This one is called Whisper. You can see it's a very soft, light color. I'm trying to keep all of these colors a bit on the lighter side. And I'm just going to pounce all around the stencil. I think this is a DecoArt stencil. I'm not sure. I'll still have links down below for some pretty stencils to use. But you know what? Since you painted the back of your image already with the two coats of chalk paint, and it does not have to be chalk paint, you can use acrylic paint on this. Since you've protected that image and you've allowed it to pop, you could use any color here for the stencil because it's not going to show through on your napkin. Now, I wanted some colors that matched my napkin or blended well with the napkin. the original background color anyway, because we already know those colors are complementary because they look so pretty on the napkin. And I just blended them in. You can blend chalk with chalk, acrylic with chalk, and ideally you want to make a very light coat in your first attempt at stenciling, and while it's wet you want to go back in with this pouncer brush and just add a little bit more color. It will just add a little bit of depth to your image. And then what happens is you just put this aside to dry. Thank you for subscribing, my friends. If you will notice in the lower right-hand corner of your video, there is a pair of scissors down there with a little circle in it. If you click on that, then you will be subscribed to my channel. Thank you for that. Thank you for all of your comments and likes. And I am also on Facebook at Upcycle with Decoupage. Like and follow the page and you'll get notifications from Facebook whenever I put a new video out. And guys, don't forget, I have an ebook called Successful Decoupage Every Time. That will be in the link down below. You can turn your smart device into a Kindle for free and download my ebook for $4.99. Okay, so now we're back and everything has dried. So I'm going to pull up the tape. It's pretty easy. I'm working on some 3 mL plastic down there to keep my surface, my table, clean from all this paint. And you'll notice now that you have this beautiful stencil. There's the bird. I would like to paint this a little bit more. You could leave it the way that it is, but don't forget you're going to put a backing on here anyway, which is probably just a piece of cardboard. So what I'm going to do is try to stay within the color scheme, and I'm going to add another color in back of these. These are all kind of light blue-green colors, so I'm just going to pounce some more paint all over the back of this. And I'll mention two things that are kind of interesting here. First of all, this has to dry, and then I'm going to put this other coat of paint on it. I'll put two coats on it, and I'm going to show you why. I let this dry. And now that it's dry and we flip this over, let me show you something. Can you see the tiny crackles in there? I have to clean the front of the glass, I'm aware of that. But you see those tiny crackles in there? That was an unexpected consequence. That just meant the decoupage glue wasn't completely dried. When I added the chalk paint over the damp decoupage glue, it created fine crackles, which I'm okay with. If you want to avoid that, make sure the decoupage glue is completely dry. And now I'm showing you what I did with that frame. I painted it with the same white chalk paint that I put on the back of the image by DecoArt. I put one coat of that all around the frame. I pounced it on, and then I used this Extreme Sheen metallic paint in a color called Pearl, which is clearly white. And I got this beautiful kind of aged effect on my frame. So here is how our finished project looks. And considering that this started out looking like this, which I would have never used or hung anywhere, I'm really excited that this now looks like this and is more in alignment with the room that I'm putting it into, with all the colors. And don't forget, you could get like 3 of those little miniature frames and do this same type of thing, have them match your bathroom or your coffee station, wherever you'd like. You could do this on a much larger scale too. And there's so much you can do with these napkins or any papers that you want to decoupage. You can follow these same instructions. So once again, my friends, thank you so much for tuning in, for subscribing, for sticking with me. And I will see you next week or the week after with another video. I hope you're enjoying your summer, and take care out there, my friends. Bye-bye.